SoCal show. Today I'm with my favorite baker in the world, Dean Kim. I think most people in Orange County know him, and if you don't, you're going to want to know about him. We're in his warehouse, or his bakery, sorry, at OC Baking Company in Orange, and he's going to tell us a little bit about what he does and why he does it. So, good to see you, Dean.
How are you doing?
On this beautiful Wednesday.
Yes.
Hopefully we'll get some rain. But I have some questions about bakery.
Okay.
And are making bread. So tell us how you got interested in making bread to begin with.
Gosh, this is about 25 years ago. I think a lot of people get attracted by what they love and their passion. Me, it was the smell, mm-hmm. and it was fresh bagels in the morning. I just felt that smell was so intoxicating that I just had to learn more and more about the whole baking process. And this was in the Bay Area. And then that's what I chose. I chose baking products because it's something that interests me and it gives me passion and it makes me money. So that's why.
And what does a typical day look like for you?
Well, usually every morning I wake up, I get to the bakery, look at numbers, and then look at the bread. Then after that, I go through the mix schedules and look at all the numbers we have to do for that day. Mm-hmm. And try to get my team to tell me exactly how we're gonna approach it. And then from there, they work at it. I usually periodically come in the morning and I'm here late night to watch the final product come out every day.
And approximately how many loaves are you baking a day?
We do about 20 to 30,000 units a day.
Wow, yeah. And tell me some of the places that you're serving, or restaurants, hotels?
We do a lot of restaurants, a lot of hotels. We do a lot of event centers.
Approximately how many?
Roughly about 175 to 200 daily.
Wow, that's crazy.
Yeah, it is crazy because my concept was a small little bakery, but it ended up getting bigger and bigger. And this is my last one. I'm not opening up anymore.
And what are you most proud of, Dean?
I'm proud of being a part of a family in hospitality. I mean, all of us are friends and we all get to, and you know, all of us, it's great because I'm in a position where I can help them with causes, and this community, the city of Orange, has been heaven sent. It's a blessing to be in this part of the city right now. So, you know, there's so many things, positives, that I can tell you that we try to achieve in bread. And it's just, it's pretty remarkable. You know?
And can you tell me about some of your favorite loaves that you make?
Yeah, I love our sourdough. You know, it's from a sourdough culture that I created over 20 years ago, and I kept it going here. And I like the more plainer stuff, sourdough, a nice baguette, you know, is my thing. More flavorful bread is more for what people and chefs want, but for me, I like a nice Italian, a nice sourdough, or a nice little French baguette.
All right, do you love your olive bread though?
Uh-huh.
And you made a cheese bread.
Yes.
I like your different breads. Well, I like everything.
Yeah.
But, well, yeah.
You know, you have to go by, I can't make bread by what I want. Mm-hmm. I have to make bread by what the consumer wants.
Right, so. That's true. Where do you see yourself in 5 years?
Retired. You know?
Winning this whole thing. Running away to Alaska or something?
I don't know. You know, we'll see. You know, 5 years is, you know, the bakery is running itself, basically. It does a great job. In 5 years, you know, I don't know. I told you my wife and I are trying to work on having children. So
that's
something that is going to take up more of my time. And, you know, try to get some, you know, from some answers like from Chef D, Bill Bracken, those kind of guys who really, you know, Pascal, who really are striving to help people more and more. Because we are very fortunate in this industry.
That's very true. Tell me something. I love that answer. That was great. Uh-huh. Tell me something might not know about baking? Like, is there a secret or tip? I know supposedly it's going to rain today.
Yeah, you know, every day is different. You have to kind of vary your dough towards the environment you're in. If it's hot, it's going to be cold. If the flour has, you know, is a little too strong, you know, we have to put more hydration in it. Mm-hmm. You know, there's a lot of things you have to look and see before you start mixing that product. And also, you know, how it's going to be baked that day. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, you know, you basically don't want to sell a place of use your bread for dinner. You don't want to be the first bake out. You want to bake it kind of like toward the wee hours in the morning,
right,
so that they get the freshest product possible. Mm-hmm. So there's a lot of science to it, but luckily we've been doing it so long, we kind of have a good gauge on everything.
Well, in a few minutes, we're going to go inside. And
yes, definitely.
But I just want to walk you through, since it is a little noisy in there, we won't be able to be doing a great interview. So tell us through the processes. We're going to be going from one...
We're going to go to the mix room.
Okay.
From the mix room, we're going to go to the makeup room where we do all of our shaping. Mm-hmm. And then we're going to go to the oven room.
Okay.
Okay, right now we're in our shaping room, which is kind of slow right now. But right now they're hand forming some Italian rolls there. They're dividing it out, which is... which we're going to bake off probably in the wee hours in the morning.
Okay.
And here is where we shape all of our baguettes. It's a Moran line, which I love because, you know, it does the work of 10 people. That, you know, shapes, divides all the baguettes and proofs them up. And all we have to do is tray them up for the clients.
Very cool.
Comes from bottom top. Now with the convection oven, the heat's hitting it all over the place. This heat is coming up from the bottom up.
Got it.
So it's a longer, more mature bake, but like I said, with technology and bread and baking now, we have things like this, which is like, you know, loaders that load them in automatically. You don't have to load them in with a peel anymore. You can take it out with a loader, you know, so it saves so much time you know, your body. By working with the machines now, technologies.
No more people.
No more people. These are rack ovens, which are convection ovens, and it's just a bunch of air hitting the inside of it like crazy. So, it makes the bread come up fast and give it a thin crust. And usually, you want to bake your hamburger buns or little smaller breads out of these type of ovens. It's kind of like your oven if you have a convection oven at home.
Right.
It's almost the same thing, but this one has steroids.
It's spinning.
It's spinning.
Yeah.
It's like, the air is going to get to it. So it's like a big mamba jamba oven. That's all it is.
And everything's it's perfectly, it's all happening
yes.
at the same time.
Yes, because the air is hitting it in like three different directions. So there's like a vortex, a tunnel going on, and air, fire is spinning.
It's
okay, it's all right. My bakers are keeping me out. So. That's far bake, that's good.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Degas the bread a little bit.
Okay.
To get the internal gas out of it. Because sometimes if you don't do it, it'll blow up on one side.
Yeah.
The air needs to get out.
Yeah.
So, this is some of the finished products we do.
Okay. Thank you.
But, you know, we do this every day.
Mm-hmm.
So this is like just a small portion of the first base coming out because a lot of these things are going to be sliced.
So let's say someone's watching this and they're like, oh, I got to get that bread. How can they do it? You're at the farmer's market?
We're at the farmer's market, the Orange Home Farmer's Market here locally in Orange every Saturday from 9 to 1.
Okay.
And also, you could go to the butchery. We do have bread there.
In Santa Ana.
Limited amount, but we do have bread there.
Okay.
You know, or if you know someone who knows me, tell them to give me a call.
Okay. Good. Well, thank you so much.
No problem.
Thank you for being a part of Greer SoCal Show. We're super excited to be here with Dean Kim. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.